coverage you can count on.
It's a case that put APD, its officers, and its practices under a microscope, the Kenneth Ellis wrongful death lawsuit. After a jury awarded his family more than $10 million, we asked what, if any, lessons APD is taking away from this. What Target 7's Lauren Zukalik found may surprise you.
And I further understand you've come to a verdict.
It's one of the biggest black eyes the department has ever faced. A jury finding the city liable for keeping an embattled officer on the force, an officer who ended up shooting and killing a veteran with PTSD, who had a gun to his head and was high on meth.
It's a troubling situation.
So what, if anything, is changing at APD because of this specific case? The short answer? Not much, because Chief Ray Schultz says they've already made changes. For instance, officers now face intervention more quickly if they start exhibiting concerning behavior.
Which includes face-to-face contact with supervisors, upper-level command members of the department, and may include other interventions to include assessments and interviews by the department psychologist.
But ready for this? We've just learned that the officer that shot and killed Kenneth Ellis, the officer that's been under so much scrutiny, right now is up for a promotion.
The officer, you know, had the right to participate in a process. The promotional process is actually conducted by an outside firm that does testing and analysis.
This, even after a jury determined the city was negligent for keeping the officer on the force. We pressed Schultz further, but didn't get very far.
Do you worry about the message that sends?
I think he's on the promotional list.
A $10 million settlement, but the lessons learned, still unclear. For Target 7, I'm Lauren Zukalik.
The city is appealing the settlement, so officials were not able to talk in detail about the officer's future with the department.